We're here to help you.
You need us.
So worried.
Silence is lonely.
We didn't know where you'd gone.
We're here to help you.
Don't worry. You can trust us.
Trust us.
Senua, it's us. We won't leave you.
Hello.
Don't leave us. We're here.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there.
Listen to us.
Sit.
Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl. Oh, isn't she?
Look up.
So clever.
There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd. Son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid
the
treasure.
Feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
Turn back.
It's dangerous.
What's
that?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
You killed her.
The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua, it's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a plan.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you
see them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll go out. She can do it. She can't do it. Go. The light's gone out. Run. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
Look.
these portals. Symbols are pointless. The meaning. Mother's here. What have you collected? There's nothing behind the door.
Save Dillian.
This is just another trial.
Just another trial.
Just to distract her from her real mission.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rain go in search of Fafnir.
Torch is going out.
No, it's not. It's going to run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
Out.
She's too slow.
It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Thank you.
She hasn't.
She did it. She's done it.
Well done.
This place. It reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
Yes. Send me an answer, sword.
Searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming.
Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey.
The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is there.
He's always watching you.
The beast is there. You're never safe from him.
You can feel it. She needs to find him.
Come, Claudius.
She's found it.
She lost it and she has to fight it.
I can feel it. Where is it?
To leave the torch alight.
End it.
save her from the darkness.
Zimbal was trying to save her from the darkness.
But she wouldn't
listen. Stupid.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. It's all her fault.
All her fault.
She's so weak. She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn? When will she learn?
She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can see.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of Hellblade. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
The light will never pass.
The darkness has come,
and she'll die. What's she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking? Is she going to get there?
You killed us. You killed us.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Reaches the roasted heart to see if it is done. He burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Come back. I hear for you. I'm coming. Zillion, I see you.
The beast has killed.
No. You're not taking him from me.
I warn you, Senua. I can smell your
blood. No!
You betrayed your god.
I am leaving with him.
You turned your back on me. That is why Dillion will rot in hell.
Thank you.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain to trust you. As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.